What's up, guys, and welcome back to Planet 2. We're back, and this is going to be a very important episode. We are going to be adding some new animals, we are going to be renovating some of our habitats, and we are going to be trying to make better conditions for these animals. So, you guys know, over the past few episodes, we have been focusing more on the breeding side of things. I mean, obviously, that's the name of the game here. You breed, you get new offspring, you release them to the wild, you get conservation credits, you can use those credits to be able to get better animals. That's kind of the business that we're in. So, we started breeding. Our Springbok have been going crazy with breeding. Our ostriches have been going crazy with breeding. We've had some hippo breeding, we've had some crocodile breeding, we've had all kinds of breeding going on, and it's all very exciting. We get these cute new animals and that sort of thing. However, it does come with some problems. So you guys know, over the course of the last couple of episodes, we have had some animals that are starting to get a little agitated, and we're running out of space because we're breeding, we're bringing in babies, and then there's not enough space for all of these new animals to roam, and we're having some issues. So the Springbok here are definitely having issues. You guys can see there's a lot of stress. There aren't really enough plants or hard shelter or anything like that for these guys, so these guys are in trouble. The black bears over here are not doing the best either. You guys can see they don't have enough space, especially on the climbing side of things. If we go over into our climbing, we're less than half of where it should be. Trying to think of who else. I think the ostriches are good. They just had a bit of a dirty pen, which we just cleaned up, so they're solid. Actually, one of them just got listerosis. That's another thing, as we're starting to get a lot more of these diseases, which is not good. But yeah, the ostriches are good. I think that's the primary concern, though. I think these guys could use a little bit more space. No, I guess they're okay. They could use a little bit more enrichment and stuff, and they could use that interspecies bonus. So I think what we're gonna do today is we are gonna mix some things up. I think we're gonna give the black bear some more space. I think we're gonna mix the African buffalo with the ostriches over here. And then I also think we're gonna give the gems box some more space as well. And we're gonna add in some new little exhibits over here, like these guys. We haven't added to these in a while, and I figured, you know, typically I like to add an animal every episode, so we can add these. That'll be small additions, and then of course we're going to go through those huge renovations. So it's going to be kind of a fun, kind of an exciting day. We're going to really spruce up this zoo quite a bit, and I'm ready for it. So let's just get straight into it. We're going to grab some of these guys, and I'm going to put this in as close as we can, maybe something like that. So we could put that there, and then we need to, can we get some paths to match up? I think it's too close. Bam, something like that is kind of what I was looking for there, and then we can grab another one. I mean, this isn't gonna be the prettiest thing in the world, but we gotta do what we gotta do, you know what I mean? We can have this one go like this, and then we can have that connected. Can we put a path here? We gotta figure out the best way to do these. Yeah, that's not really gonna work. I wanted to line all four up, but I don't think that's gonna work. We could do a double here instead, which could be kind of interesting. I kind of like the idea of a double. That's pretty nice. Let me center it a little bit better. Something like that is kind of cool. So we could have two new animals side by side. I really like that. And honestly, we could probably eventually delete these, and then we could just have doubles run all the way down. But yeah, this is solid. Let's view the exhibit animal market and see. Ooh, what is this? Are you kidding me? An Amazonian giant centipede. Let me see what the most exciting things are. Western diamondback. It's gonna cost us $1,100, but he brings in quite a bit of hype. A lesser Antillean iguana. Looks like he's kind of a white iguana. All right, I'm down for that. You know what? I'm down for both of those. We've got puff adders. Can we put two? Oh shoot, I adopted one. I meant to say look at the Zoopedia. Can we put two puff adders in the same thing? We can put two puff adders in there. So we can make some baby snakes, dude. I'm down for it. So we want a male puff adder. I'm gonna go ahead and adopt the male puff adder there. We can have up to five. Hold on a second. So does that mean we could put more Gila monsters in here? Let me see your Zoopedia. I didn't even think about putting multiple of these guys in here. We can have up to four Gila monsters. And then over here, this is our boa, right? I'm pretty sure this is our boa constrictor. And let me see his Zoopedia. We can have up to two. And the current one in here is a male, Diego. So I'm gonna put a female boa constrictor in there. And then we're also gonna get some other Gila monsters. We need female boas and female Gilas. Here's a female Gila, go ahead and get her. Get a second female Gila. And then we need a boa. There's a male boa. There's only a male boa available. So we're gonna wait. I'm gonna see if we can find a female on the market eventually, because that would be pretty dope. But look at this, dude. Now we're gonna be able to put some new, I don't know why I didn't think that we could put more of those in there, but we can totally add more of these animals. So I'm gonna put both of these female Gilas in here, and then we're gonna put both of these puff adders in here. I'm gonna go ahead and send these guys to the zoo. They should be okay. Let me see the Zoopedia on this. We're definitely gonna have to fix up their situation in here. But we could have up to 5 of these, and we currently have 2 in there, right? There's a male and a female. Can we get any more females? There's another female right here. We'll adopt her. Send her to the zoo. Put her in there. We've got 3 in there now. Look at those guys. Pretty cool looking. Now what we definitely need to do is start doing research on those, but let's finish up here. We need to see more of these animals. I'm going to open this up so we can have everything. What do you guys think? Do we want an iguana? Do we want a yellow anaconda, a western diamondback? I'm gonna say this iguana is pretty sick. How many of these can we put in one? 1 to 2. So if we could get a male and a female, lesser Antillean iguana. Let me see if we have males and females. We've only got 2 females. Shoot. I kinda wanna keep the breeding up. We could get 2 giant desert hairy scorpions. Let me see these guys, 1 to 6. Okay, what do you guys think about that? Giant desert hairy scorpions? I mean, they're pretty cool. I'm gonna get them. We're gonna get this one right here, and then we're gonna get this one right here. Are there any others? Giant desert hairy scorpion. There's more males. I'm kinda looking for females if we can. I guess we could get, let's just put these 2 in here and hope for the best. I think we're gonna be okay. So we're gonna take these and we're gonna send them to the zoo. All right, so we've got that. Now we're gonna wanna hit play. So these are officially in the thing. And then we're gonna wanna go in here to our vet research, which we've been doing really well. And we wanna get, we wanna keep on Listeriosis because we've got more animals with that. I've ventured to say that our hippos are probably good now. So I'm gonna move her from the hippos to the puff adder. And then I'm gonna move, shoot, I kind of wanted more on the ostrich, but I'm gonna move it to the scorpion for right now. So we're gonna let that go. Now let's see what these guys actually want. Let me check and make sure. I'm gonna go ahead and pause this while we're looking at this. We wanna make these guys as happy as possible. We want the humidity a little bit higher. So we're gonna set this up around like a 17%, maybe like a 20%. Looks like the temperature is good, maybe like a 25%. 25 is good. Then we're gonna check on these guys. Exhibit's not good. Temperature needs to be fixed here. So we need to bring this down to like a 30, 29. And we need to bring this up a lot. Make sure these guys are in good hands. I think we might need to go to like a, 85. It's probably gonna be pretty good. So at least we're gonna have the temperature right. Obviously, I'm gonna say an 80. Oh, 80's too high. We're gonna say a 70, 75. What's this over here? Damaged barriers. We're gonna go ahead and call a mechanic on that. Research is done. More damaged barriers over here. Or is this the same one? No, I think we're good. So look at this. I mean, this is awesome, man. We gotta turn all these things on. Can I click that? Yeah, we're gonna put this on the puff adder. We can put this on our scorpion. Put this on our scorpion as well. They can't really come up to this side, so we need to put some paths over here, but we're gonna put that on the puff adder. Dude, these things are sick. I honestly, like, they're so easy to take care of. I love these little guys. Can we have this go like that? And then bring it like this? Okay, kinda ugly. Ah, we don't need that, we're good. And then we can also add some facilities. We're gonna add some tip jars around here. So we'll put one right there. And one right there. All right, looks pretty good to me. Cool, so that's good. We're gonna let this run through the night, but you know, like I said, that was just kind of our addition to the zoo. We're definitely gonna customize this up and make it look a little bit better for them, make them a little bit happier as we unlock research for our layout. But now it's gonna be time to get to these guys. And I don't wanna do it at night because it's kind of hard to see. So we're just gonna fast forward on ahead and I'll see you guys in the morning. Oh boy, our crocs are getting freaky at night. They're mating already. Oh my goodness. We've already got baby crocs over here and we're already getting more baby crocs. When do these guys actually, they're juvenile still. When do they become adulthood? Is it like 15 years old, dude? We're gonna have to make a second crocodile exhibit. They're gonna be so upset when they have more babies and there's more crocs laying around, you know what I mean? We're gonna have to come up with a second crocodile exhibit. There is absolutely no doubt about that. That's going to be an issue. We've got Jimsbok about to mate. The Jimsbok thing is not great right now. The habitat's just not clean, and that's because we have so many Jimsbok in one little area. So trust me, we're going to be fine. We're going to be okay. We've got an aardvark about to mate. Dude, this is absolute craziness. Love is in the air here in October of 2023. But what was I going to say? Yeah, the Jimsbok, there's too many of them in one small area, so that's part of what we're going to fix here. We're going to give them a much bigger exhibit, and they should be much happier. So we'll see if we can fix that up. Looks like it's starting to become daylight. Can see the sun kind of coming over the mountains here. Let's go ahead and speed this up all the way. Try to bring that good old sunshine out. Things are crazy. Like this, I feel like the last few episodes, I've started to become a little bit overwhelmed with how quickly things are happening and how quickly, you know, offspring are popping up and all kinds of stuff like that. Shoot. What's going on here? We only have 4 African wild dogs in here. They haven't really been breeding properly. We need to get better dogs for breeding, if you want me to be honest. About to have more offspring. This is just going to be absolutely insane. Holy cow. We honestly probably could put our offspring in storage. That's not a bad idea, but we'll see what happens. We've got a disease risk over here, so we're going to have to call a keeper over here. I'm going to slow this down. All right, we've got daylight, ladies and gents. We've got daylight. I'm going to go ahead and pause it. Oh, broken barrier. Animals may escape. Who did that? Oh, shoot. Call a mechanic over here. Don't you dare. Don't you dare. I moved him right before he got there. Come on, mechanic. Mechanic's right there. Okay, so my plan, what are we gonna do here? Well, we are gonna take this Jimsbok area, which you guys can see, some of them are doing okay, some are up in the 76% range, but some are just not doing well. There's just not enough space. We are gonna take this Jimsbok exhibit and we are gonna move it over to this side over here. We are gonna make a huge new exhibit and we are gonna make sure that these guys have enough room for themselves as they are currently, as well as all the babies they're gonna have in the future. So let me just go ahead and grab a wooden fence. How tall do we make it? I wanna make sure I know. 4.15 meters. We're gonna make a huge wooden fence around this entire area and give them plenty of space. Bam! Ain't no way they're not gonna be happy with that amount of space, and they're gonna have plenty of area to roam and kind of mess around and play around and that sort of thing. It's a little shallow. Ooh, shoot. I think we might wanna make it a little bit deeper. But yeah, that's kind of the main idea I had here. So I'm gonna go ahead and we definitely need to make this a little bit deeper, but you guys get the idea. So looking at our water treatment facilities, it looks like we already have one in this area that's covering this right here. So I'm gonna go ahead and actually, I just realized that somehow our aardvark pond is not being treated by any water facilities, but it's still clean. So we're gonna have to keep an eye on that. But yeah, if we put a little pond in this area, then they're gonna have a little pond, which honestly they did not have before. So it's gonna be kind of nice that they have that. So I'm gonna put a pond there, and then I'm gonna make their little shelter habitat thing back here. We're gonna give them a big area where they can just kind of hang out and relax. And that's honestly the biggest reason why they're unhappy right now is because they don't have enough hard shelter. We're down to 29%. So we need something massive. I honestly don't even know if we can build a rock shelter that big. We could try, but it'd probably be better off to go with the huge long pieces and just make it look really nice. So I think that's what I'm gonna try to do. Oh my gosh, I'm tempted. That is ridiculous, bro. So we unlocked this, we've been unlocking different types of shelters from our research. These actually go with the theme of our zoo a lot better than anything that we can build naturally. I mean, I like our rock caves, to be honest. I do really like the look of those, but these actually look pretty cool too. I'm gonna move this forward so it's not hanging over the fence like that. I want it to look nice and legit. Yeah, that's perfect. So we could put a little one like that. That might not be big enough though. I mean, I'm looking at the size of that. I guess it is, it's pretty significantly bigger than what we currently have, but that, dude, that big boy, I kind of want to put this somewhere. So now you've got the tedious job of grabbing all this stuff and moving it over to the new habitat. So I'm not gonna bore you guys with that. However, we do have a much bigger habitat, so it's gonna be kind of nice. I think we're gonna have more space to be able to do fun stuff. So like previously, obviously you couldn't overdo it with the coverage, but now we have bigger space, so we're gonna be able to cover more. We're gonna be able to put more plants in here, which is gonna be kind of nice. But yeah, we're gonna move all these little grazing feeders and all these other little things over. And we're gonna get them a nice little setup. I mean, it makes me kind of sad because obviously people had a much better view of these guys over there, and I'm sure we're gonna get some complaints that when they're back in the back, all the guests aren't gonna be able to see them. Wah wah wah. The view from here is okay, is usually what the feedback is. But I mean, to be honest, this is gonna be nice that it's a little bit bigger, a little bit more appropriate space for this many. You know what I mean? Like it's. I feel like they were kind of being treated a little poorly in that last spot, so this is definitely going to be a lot more appropriate. Currently moving all the bedding over here. So yeah, even though it looks to be about the same size, I think there's definitely more space for them to lay in here. There's a higher ceiling, stuff like that. I mean, we could make a cave with a higher ceiling, but let's be real. This is a little... It's a little better. It still looks pretty good too. I think once we kind of doll it up with some cool plants and stuff around it, I think it's really going to be pretty cool. It's a little bit better of a shelter for them to get out and away from all the tourists. So our final piece here should be good with that there. All right, looking pretty solid. Now are there any other toys or anything back here? Obviously, we're going to have to move a lot of the plant life and stuff, but I want to get them over in here. I want to get our terrain set. And then we're gonna worry about all that stuff. So I guess we could put a little hanging thing over here. I'm trying to put all their toys and stuff over in front of the windows so they'll go play with it in front of all the guests, but I think that's pretty solid. Oh shoot, we've got a cooler. We're gonna need a few of these bad boys, huh? I'm just so sad, dude. I feel like this is such a good looking exhibit, but we just outgrew it in terms of space. It got too crazy. So I'm gonna send all these guys to the trade center, and then we're gonna move all of them into that new habitat. And from there, we can start customizing the new digs. It's gonna be a little bit tougher to make it as pretty, to be honest. When you have more space, it's tougher to make sure that it doesn't get like overcrowded or anything, but we're gonna try our best. We're literally getting notifications that the cleanliness is bad as we're doing this. So I think we're making the right decision here. Ooh, I didn't even think about this, but we can bring a staff path out like this. And then we could put a little habitat gate right over here. Beautiful. So we're gonna be able to let the staff in right there, away from all the public. That's nice. All right, I like it. Let me make sure. I'm gonna come in here. We want to make sure that the mechanic visits every 3 months. Every month, yeah. All right, that sounds good. Cool. So now what we're gonna do is we are going to go to our storage, and we are gonna move all of these gyms back into their new habitat. It looks like a lot of our staff are running out and around this way to get to it. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna give them a little cheat sheet path. We're gonna open up a little pathway right here. And then we can do a little staff path just to kind of make things a bit more appropriate. Shoot. It's kind of, I don't want it to be ugly though. Something like that, I feel like. And then we can take this, we can move this a little bit more back like this. And we could duplicate this along so people still can't really see what's going on back there, but at least the staff have better access to all areas of the park. Boom. Something like that. Yeah, that's pretty good. I mean, you can kind of see like one building back there. That doesn't cause any issues. And now if we hit play, I think some of our people are gonna be able to come straight through here. Perfect. Made it a little bit easier for them. I like it. Gotta make sure they've got those direct paths and access ways to these areas. So we've got our first gym's bot coming in here. Let's go ahead and get these guys in their new little habitat. Holy cow, so many of them coming in. Let me make sure they're happy. So far, it actually looks like they're kind of perfect. They're happy with everything. We're definitely gonna add a ton of grass. I mean, they have pretty much unlimited grass. They could take some rock. They want at least a little bit of sand. So I think we're gonna have sandy area over here by their little habitat, and we're gonna do a lot of grass elsewhere. So maybe long grass over here that transitions to short grass that goes to the sand. So that's what we're gonna do. Let's go ahead and get our tool out. Let's have some fun with this. So I'm gonna go ahead and do a bunch of long grass here, and then we're gonna transition it to short grass. That was a big paintbrush. Little too big for my liking. Probably bring some of the long grass out. Have this go most of the way, and then we're gonna bring out some sand. There we go. It's not bad. Oh, we need more sand, though. All right. Wants a little bit more sand. They really like their sand, huh? I mean, that makes sense, though. We're out in the desert. We're going to have a bunch of sand. Where there's water, there will be grass. All right, cool. So these guys have a much bigger area now. Is there anything else that they specifically need? They want more toy enrichment. But apart from that, I mean, they're super solid here. And that we can definitely do a lot more coverage. About to inbreed. Is that going to be a problem? Do we not want inbreeding? I would venture to say you probably don't want that. Omusupe is pregnant again. Oh my goodness. All right. Things are crazy right now, but we're going to be okay. All right. So they want some more enrichment and stuff. They want more toys. And then we also definitely have to kind of doll up their space. It looks very boring right now, but we're going to be able to make it look nice. Just going to kind of move everything over that we had over here, because I really liked what we had going on over here. We need to move it all. I think there's a way you can move everything, but I'm just going to do it one at a time for now. So I don't really know what I'm going for here. I mean, we're using a lot of the same stuff we had in the last one, which I felt like we had a really good thing going in the last one. We could put these little bushes on top of this cooler. Make sure those are like that. We had these lined up along the edge last time, so we could do more of these. They're kind of cheating through the edge of the fence, but I think overall they look pretty nice. So we could put these, each little major divider like that. Not bad. I don't know why this is split up into three windows right here. Why can't we not get this to be all in one? That corner is just, oh man, we are barely over it. I guess if we took this back a little bit more, if we took this one back, I think we could make this work like that. Boom. All right. And then we can turn this into a windowed one. So that looks a little bit nicer there. Shoot. We kind of have the same thing going on right here. What is this about? Can we take these two down? Boom. Just like that. And then we can make this one specifically a window. Okay, cool. So that looks pretty nice. I mean, yeah, this is like what I said. It gets a little bit difficult. Let me see if we put one in front and one in back. That actually looks kind of cool. When it's this big, it gets a little bit more difficult to make it look nice. Just because there's so much more going on. You ride that line of, are you putting too much stuff in and overcrowding it? Versus, is there not enough stuff because it's so big? And I mean, it doesn't look bad. I like what we've done here. I like having the little rocks around here. I'm gonna put this one on top of the heater so that nobody can see that. I like what we've done, but I don't love it. I'm gonna put sand on the bottom of the grass there, sand on the bottom of the water instead of having the long grass. I feel like that looks a little bit better, but yeah, I mean, it looks nice. It's not quite as exciting as this thing was. I guess we could add a lot of these flowers and stuff in there, but it's so big. Like, do you really want to line the entire back wall with these flowers? We can, I'm down to do it, but I'm worried we do that and then it just kind of looks stupid. I guess we can try it. What are these things called? The King Protea? Or we could do these things. The Aloe Vera. Which one do we like better, do you guys think? Probably the Aloe. I feel like the Aloe looks nice. All right, I'm going to line the whole back wall with Aloe. Dude, it's 10 bucks a meter for this stuff. This is outrageous. We're going to have it start back here, and we are just going to line the entire back wall. We got to slowly turn it as we go, and we got to hope that we aren't going to get done with this, and it's going to look stupid because we wasted like 5 minutes of our time, but it's going to be all right. You Gemsbok better bring me lots of babies, dude. This is slightly ridiculous, and you guys know I'm a bit of a perfectionist, so I'm trying to make sure no clips through the wall. Make sure it's all lined up perfectly. See, like that one back there went a little bit too far. I think we made it. Boom. All right. Whole back wall lined with aloe. I mean, it doesn't do a ton for me. I guess it adds a little bit to it. Let me see how they are with coverage. We're about at max coverage here. So I don't know. I mean, we can work with this. If you guys have any ideas, feel free to leave comments. I always go back and read all the comments. But like I said, it's just when you go into a lot of space like this, it makes it kind of difficult. But hey, we had to do it for the welfare of the animals. I mean, ultimately, when you look at this and their welfare is all the way up and like literally, let me hit play here. Their welfare is at 97%. That is why we did it. It may not look quite as beautiful, but that's why we did it.